You need to accept your dog for who he is before you can start training. Because we can't just change everything. And sometimes I have to burst bubbles when we have appointments because some people would like to change everything about their dog and it's not realistic. So ask yourself the question, and it is really one of my first questions I ask in a free discovery call is, what would happen if nothing changes? And yes, there are some things that just can't stay the way they are, right? If your dog is like, whenever you start brushing him and your dog immediately bites or something like that, that can't stay like it is. I absolutely get that. But your dog has a personality and quirks that might stay the way they are. The behavior is maybe getting better with training, and if it doesn't, it might be a reason to check the training. But there are things that are just the way they are. Like my Sammy, he is a very sensitive, actually a highly sensitive dog. He will never stop being a highly sensitive dog. Yes, he can get used to grooming, he can get used to people touching him and the vet and things like that. But he will always have issues, for example, with wet floor. Like, if we are outside walking and it was raining and the ground is wet, he will always have issues and walk like some kind of, yeah, whatever. It looks a little funny, but I know that he just doesn't like that. So for me to try to get him to like rain and try to get him to be outside for hours and hours when it's raining would just be a waste of energy, to be honest. Because some things we can just accept. And we can change so many things with training. But if we don't like the personality our dogs bring with them, the more important question might be, is it worth the energy? Or would this dog be happier in a different family? And I'm not saying rehome every dog because they have some kind of issue, all right? That's not true. I have taken in all of my dogs who had issues, no matter if they were foster dogs or my dogs. All of them had issues. And we worked on them and it was wonderful and all of that. But the personality was always something I accepted or I tried to accept. Like, you cannot make a Molossa out of a herding dog. It will not happen. You could get your herding dog to be relaxed and chilled at home, but your herding dog will always have a higher excitability. They will always have a little bit more energy than like a bull mastiff has, right? That is just a given. So if you don't like an excited dog, don't get an excited dog, all right? What I want to share with you today is just that some things you can actually accept. And I want you to think about what you actually want to change for your dog and with your dog, and what you can accept. And also, if what you want to change is something that your dog can actually change. Like, you have your personality too, right? And if you are a very sensitive person, for example, somebody telling you, don't be so sensitive, how does that make you feel? Is that something that you feel like you can actually do or you want to do? It's the same thing for your dog. And very often, after we learn to accept and love our dogs unconditionally, training works so much better. And if you want to see how this looks like for leash reactivity, watch this video.